Good morning, children. This is Sumati, your social studies teacher. Today, I am continuing the topic, chapter 3, in that part 3, Earth Movements and Seasons. And the previous class, we have studied about the curvature of the Earth, rotation of the Earth, and the rotation, it takes 24 hours, day and night circles, and the day and nights, the main reason is the circle is circle of illumination. This all we studied. Now we are going to continue the revolution of the earth. And what is the revolution of the earth? The movement of the earth around the sun. The earth's tilt and revolution round the sun. The earth is revolving round the sun while rotating round its own axis. And previous we have studied that earth is rotating on its own axis. That means one movement is going on and earth is rotating itself on its own. Along with that, it is revolving around the sun. That is called revolution of the earth. So the motion of the earth around the sun is called revolution. And earth's revolution takes about 365 days and 5.556 hours, approximately 6 hours. That means 365 days, 6 hours of time it is taking. Per day, how many hours? 24 hours. When that 24 hours, only 6 hours. So, one revolution, 365 days and approximately 6 hours it is taking. So, the balance, how many hours were left? 18 hours were left. So, that 18 hours, every year 6 hours, 6 hours, 6 hours, suppose if you take it like that, 4 years, each 4 6 24. 4 years, 6 hours if we take it, that is, was one day. That is only a leap year. These all the 6 hours we are unable to calculate every year. So those were dragon to totally all the 6 hours into 1 year, that is the leap year. Okay, every 4 years we will get the leap year. Of course, this is 2020 year. This year is leap year. We got it in the February month, 29 days. Okay, one day extra. So, leap year we get 366 days, that means one day extra. So, this is the length of the year on the earth. So, 1 year, whatever the time it is taking for the revolution, this is the length of the year. And you can see that the earth just gone around the sun, it would have meant that all places would have had the same season throughout the year. Actually, the earth is going on around the sun. We can feel that all places, all the areas, we may get the same season throughout the year. But the portions that get more sunshine would keep getting it throughout the year in the same way and the vice versa. Whatever the portion, suppose it is more sunshine, that means while the revolution is going on, one portion may get the direct rays from the sun and another portion may be far away. Like that, next time, whatever the portion was away from the sun, that may get direct to the sun, and whatever that in front of the sun, that portion may be away from the sun. That means simultaneously it takes place. But this is not so, because actually, while the earth is in a straight, that axis is in a straight, suppose it may happen, half of the portion may get the sunlight, another half of the portion may won't get, like that continuation is may going on. If suppose earth is in straight, but this is not going on because the axis of the earth is in a tilt position. You know that already, we studied in the previous class. It is called slanting position or inclined position. So, the earth is little bit bending. The points in the same direction throughout the year. Because of that, tilting position is the main reason for the changing of seasons or maybe the life on the earth. And here you see that the earth's axis of rotation does not stand vertical. Here actually the earth's position is in a straight. Suppose this is the earth's axis, the earth is rotating in this way, suppose. Then the total portion of the earth gets that same lighting every day and the same position every day. But here it is in different method or different problem it is. Of course it is not a problem, it is useful to us only. It is a different way it is going on. The earth is inclined. Here you see that, that is tilt position, that is 23.5 degrees. So actually this is the equator. From equator to the north pole it is 90 degrees, but that is the right angle. But here what happened, the earth is tilting 23.5 degrees. From 90, if you reduce 23.5, the balance is 66.5 degrees. So here from the north pole to 23.5 degrees, the earth is tilting. Because of that reason, here the earth created 66.5 degrees angle. Okay, so this plane, but it is the tilting. Here it is, you see, actually earth is tilting now. So this became an equator. Actually this is the equator and this is the an imaginary line, that is axis connecting north pole to south pole. So because of this position only the earth is going on, the rotation and revolution seasons are causing. In other words, it is tilted by 23.5. That means from the 90 degrees minus 66.5 degrees, if you reduce 23.5 degrees angle it is created, that portion is tilting. Okay, now you see that perpendicular to the eclipse, ecliptic, already this I explained, I think you understood this. Now as earth revolves round the sun, earth's axis remains tilted in the same direction throughout the year. Actually while the earth is rotating or revolving, the axis is same position only. The rotation also, revolution also going on in the same way. It is not at all changing the position. It keeps pointing to the pole star, which can be seen in the north sky in the night, and this is called the polarity of axis. Actually another saying is that while the pole star, actually the earth is rotating towards the north pole, pole star is there in the sky. Night time we can see that pole star is near to us. Actually after the sun, pole star only near to us, and that pole star actually along with us, that it is also moving itself. So which can be seen in the northern sky in the night time. So this, that's why it is called polarity of axis, because the pole star, we can see as per the pole star the axis is moving. Because of that reason it is called polarity of axis. And the earth goes around the sun on a regular path. So even how the rotation is going on, 24 hours or one day it is taking, even the earth's revolution also the same way, same path or the same way it is continuous. How you are going to coming from home to school every day, and from the school to home you are going to every day, the same way, almost the same way the sun, the earth also following the around the sun while it is moving. That regular path is called orbit. And this orbit actually in the space, we cannot see that, it is an imaginary line which is made it. Always the earth is moving on that or going around the sun in the same path. And this is called orbital plane. That means it is, the path is called orbit. But which plane it is going, so every day it is going on, the same way. This year, the next year, or maybe previous years, the same way it's followed. and following. Because of that reason, that plane it is called the orbital plane. And the shape is the shape of the Earth's orbit is called elliptical. Elliptical shape means almost oval shape. Okay, it is like a egg shape. The length of the Earth's orbit, actually the Earth where it is starting and taking one revolution and coming to the same position, that's a particular place, it takes 965 million kilometers of the length. That means the way. Okay, and here you can see that how it is going on. You see, Earth's revolution is going on around the sun. See, always it moves from this direction. Actually, Earth moves from west to east, and at the same time, even this movement also, this is also you can calculate as from left hand side to right hand side. And at that time, suppose this is the month of June. You see, in the month of June, northern hemisphere is facing towards the sun. But while the 6 months completes, in the this moment, this Earth position, you see that totally southern portion is towards the sun, facing towards the sun. You see, here northern hemisphere is facing towards sun, but here southern hemisphere is facing towards the sun. So here northern hemisphere means where Asia is there, our India is there. Because of that reason, in the month of June we get the summer. At the same time, after 6 months, we feel winter and southern hemisphere feels summer. That time is December. For us, winter, no? But other two positions of the Earth, you see that means only one Earth position is different as the movement of the Earth around the sun. Here you see that the Earth at the time of March and end September, these two times are that those 2 months, the sun's rays fall directly on equator. So because of that reason, on those 2 months, particular days are there, next class we are going to teach upper study, those 2 days mostly sun's rays fall equally on total portion of the Earth. That means north to south almost it will be equal, same. Okay, this is, you see that Earth's movement around the sun, this is, and Earth's rotation, its axis. Okay, this is the Earth, how the position is there. Okay, now this is the time for ascent. What is the shape of the Earth's orbit? What is the length of Earth's orbit? How much time does the Earth take to complete one revolution? You write exact one and approximate. And what is the regular path of the Earth around the sun called? What is the imaginary line joining the north and south pole called? How many days are there in a leap year? Okay, that's all for today, children. We'll meet in the next class. Okay, bye.